Good morning to everyone. Hope the quality of audio is fine. Yeah, thank you. Okay, so in the previous, so let me recap previous session. In the previous session, we started with what is HANA Live? HANA Live are the predefined data models that are delivered by SAP, which are also known as virtual data models, VDM. VDM consists of private views, reusable views, query views, and tables. On top of tables, we have private views, on top of private views, we have reusable views. On top of reusable views, we have query views. Private views are the views that cannot be modified. Private views are consumed inside reusable views for different subject areas. Reusable views are reused inside a query view. You can modify a view, which is a reusable view, or a query view by using extension tool. We have an extension tool. By using the tool, we can modify a view. So today, what we're going to see is, we already downloaded a few virtual data models for ECC system. First thing we're going to see, how we can import those virtual data models into SAP HANA system. So let us log into HANA system. So, when we work in HANA, we have a three-tier system. One is the quality, QA, development system, and production system. Now, these virtual data models, the virtual data models that SAP provides to the customer or to its partners, these are known as HANA Live. So these are mainly for operational reporting. So HANA Live, virtual data models. Now we have to import these virtual data models into our landscape. So once we import these data models into our landscape, once we import the data models to our landscape, once we import them, we need to see the schema is same. The schema which we have developed is same. The virtual data models are already developed on a schema that is relevant to SAP. And we have our own schema. We follow our own schema naming convention. And SAP follows their own naming convention. It's always a schema and table. So tables are always are specific to schema. Tables are always specific to schema. And we develop data models on top of these tables. So what I'm trying to say is, the schemas which SAP has delivered and schemas that we are going to use may be same or different. In order to map the incoming schema, in order to map the physical, this is called the physical schema. With the authoring schema, this is called the authoring schema. In order to map both of them, we do something called schema mapping. So first we need to know what is the schema in which these data models have been developed. What is the schema that I am going to follow? For both of them we have to do schema mapping. What is the schema mapping is, when we import these data models to our system, these data models will actually search on the same schema that these data models have been developed. These data models have been developed, so it's going to search on the same schema in the development system of the customer. Because the same data models will be used by different customers with the same schema name. And all the customers may not maintain the same schema name. So first we need to check the dependency. Whether we have the schema mapping in place. Otherwise it's going to throw an error. So either we need to have the same schema name, or we need to map the existing schema with our schema. So let's log into HANA Studio. So now, right click on the system, click log on. Provide the username as best and provide the password. Welcome 123. Click on Window, click on Show View, click on Quick View. Once click on Quick View, scroll to the bottom. Here you find Schema Mapping. Click on Schema Mapping. So Schema Mapping is on a specific system. What system you want to map? We want to map the development system. Select the development system, click Next. So here you see the authoring schema. And a physical schema. The authoring schema is the incoming schema. The physical schema is the schema that is existing in HANA. So I know the authoring schema or the incoming schema is SAP ECC. Now how do you know? HANA Lite delivers predefined documentation. In this documentation, you can find the name of the schema is SAP underscore ECC. So we can map an authoring schema, SAP underscore ECC, with the physical schema. Because this is already existing, remove this. So I'm mapping with the physical schema. So let's say I map with best user. And click finish, for example. So in this fashion, we have to map with the physical schema and click finish. So once you finish, the schema mapping is done. We know the incoming schema and the physical schema. Now once this is finished, now once you import, the data models will be imported. Now let us next go to this is the first step. This is step number one. Before even importing the data models, we have to perform this activity. Otherwise, data models will fail and no model will get activated. Step number two. The step number two, we have to import the VDM. In order to import the VDM, we have a deliver unit option. We have a deliver unit. So let me show you. Go to HANA Studio, click File, click Import. Click SAP HANA Content. Under Content, you have a Deliver Unit. Now what is a Deliver Unit? Deliver Unit is an object that is used to transport packages from one system to a different system. Delivery unit is an object that is used to transport packages from one system to a different system. these delivery units have an extension dot tgz. These delivery units have an extension dot tgz. So inside these delivery units, you have these VDMs. Inside the delivery unit. So we need to import these delivery units to HANA system. So these delivery units consist of package. Under package, you have VDMs. Under this VDM, again they are classified into private views, reuse views, and query views. But these VDMs, as we just discussed, now the data models are dependent upon the tables, are dependent upon the tables. And these tables are under catalog. So what is the dependency? Again, I'm showing you one more dependency over here. So now the dependency is, once you import a VDM, a private view, a reuse view, or a query view, all these three are going to check for the dependencies from the catalog area, that is from the tables. They're going to check whether these dependencies are there or not. If the dependencies are not there, the data model is failing. It is not active. First one is schema mapping. Once you perform the schema mapping, it imports. You can import now. Once you import, it says the respective dependent tables for the data models are not existing. So that's why we cannot open it. So how do you know? Because there are hundreds of data models. How do you know what tables we need to get for what data models? By using an option, generate SLT file. You have an option called generate SLT file. Once you generate this option, now we know what are the dependencies on the data models, what tables we require. Now, so the point here is, delivery unit consists of extension .tgz, the VDMs, once imported, has private, reuse, query views. In order to check the dependencies of each of the views, we have to generate the SLT file in which the models are inactive. Once we generate the SLT file, based on this file, now this is the landscape of this whole system. So like this, we have three systems. Connected to each other. So this is the ECC. So everything is the ECC on the top. ECC development, ECC QA, ECC production, and this is the SLT. SLT development, SLT QA, SLT production. This is a development system. This is SLT development, sorry, HANA development. HANA development, HANA QA, and HANA production. Now, where are we importing these data models? I'm importing the VDM into the development system. Now, I generated a file which is generate SLT file. Now, I have the list of tables. Now, what do I have to do with the list of tables? I go to the SLT system. I go to LTRC. Obviously, we know we have to create a connection of the configuration wherein ECC development points to SLT development, SLT development points to HANA development. In the SLT LTRC, we take all the list of tables. We enter in here. Once you enter here, schema mapping is already in place because when you create the configuration, based on the configuration, there is a schema in HANA system. So we already mapped the incoming schema with the authoring schema. So once it triggers, all the tables will be available in the catalog. Now once all the dependent tables are available in the catalog, now we can activate the data model. Once activated the data model, then you can expose to the business objects, business intelligence platform, BOBI platform. So in the same way, now from here, so once we completed these activities in the development system, then we have to transport these data models or the virtual data models to QA. We have to test them and then transport to production. Now again, when you basically move them, before you move them from development to quality system, before we move them, we need to again schedule the jobs in the SLT quality. Again, get all the tables, because we are not transporting the tables. We don't transport the table. We only transport the virtual data model. Tables come from the ECC QA to HANA QA using SLT QA, the same way, transport to production. So, repeating the same step again until the production. So, when you import these data models, there are basically three ways we can import. One is using a developer, a delivery unit. Now, delivery unit is the only method that is supported by VDM. You have another mode called developer mode. And you also have something called support mode. You have three modes, delivery unit mode, developer mode, support mode. What's the difference between three of them? And delivery unit is used for VDM, and when you develop your own custom models, for example, you develop a custom model, you only want to transport a single object rather than group of objects. Delivery unit is mainly used to transport group of objects. A developer mode is used to transport single objects. A support mode is used for troubleshooting. When you want to find out root cause analysis, you use the support mode. So, you see all these options are available over here. A delivery unit, a developer mode, and support mode is available in the administration perspective. Only modelers can perform delivery unit in developer mode, and support mode is taken care by the administration guys. So let us select delivery unit. Select the delivery unit mode to import objects available at the server or at the client location in the form of .tgz files. Delivery unit mode to import objects available at server or client location in the form of .tgz files. Select the delivery unit. Click Next. Select the instance. Click Next. Select the required file to import content objects. This is only for content objects. So do we have in the server or in the client? We have in the client. So we'll select the client. Click Browse. On the other day, we downloaded them. So the other day, these are the data models we downloaded. So we'll go to HCO HBA ECC. Double click on this. So here you find HCO HBA ECC. Double click on this. Once you select the model, so here you find the predefined data models. Billing document, item query, all these are predefined data models. See, all these are calculation views. So you have more than 1,000 calculation views that are delivered by SAP. And click Finish. Obviously, most of the data models will fail because still we have to get the dependencies. Now when you have ECC on HANA, in the main car scenario, the models will get activated because it has all the dependencies for the given tables inside the data model. But we are implementing in a sidecar scenario. We're seeing a sidecar scenario. So in a sidecar scenario, once you have this data model, we have to get the dependency by using generate SLT file. So click Finish. Once we finish, we started to import the delivery unit. It failed because there are no dependencies. Double click on this. So you have an error. You have a lot of errors. A lot of errors will come. Just click OK and ignore all the errors. Now we should be able to see the data models, but inactive. expand the content, go to the package SAP, expand the SAP package, expand HBA package, expand ECC package. Here we see the calculation views. Expand calculation views. And here we see the all the predefined calculation views that are provided by SAP. These are known as virtual data models. Inside these virtual data models we have private, reuse and query views. Now, this is one interface that we can see all the data models. Now, especially for HANA Live, we have a browser-based application that is provided by SAP, which is known as HANA Live Browser. It's known as HANA Live Browser. So, let's open the browser. Let's open the browser. So to open the browser, I have a link over here, SAP HANA Live. So this is the, so I'll place this links in the C drive, so we all can access. I'll just copy them. I'll go to the C drive, go to the computer, go to the C drive. In here, I'll place them as so you all can access this two links. So I'll copy this link, I'll copy the link. I'll copy the link and then click start, click all program. Open Google Chrome. Let us copy paste. Let us copy paste the link. Once you copy paste the link, so here it opens up the link. View system. Give the password, click log on. So once you log on, once you log into the system, so here you see this is the HANA Live browser. Once we're inside the HANA Live browser, to the bottom we can see all views, my favorites, search, invalid views. So currently I have all the views as invalid views. The reason is the views are not active. You see, a view which is inactive is an invalid view. When I open the view is not activated. It is not in an active position. So when a view is inactive, so all these are predefined views. See, indicates the red color. Red color means the columns are not available. The schema is SAP_ECC. This is the name of the schema. And here is the table name. So this is the name of the schema and the table name. So what now the next thing we have to do is for the, all these invalid virtual data models, we have to generate this file. So here views in SAP HANA, expand SAP HBA.ECC. In here you find three categories. One is the query view. The second one is the reuse views, and third one is the private views. Now, how do you know in the HANA Studio by seeing in the view whether it is a query, reuse, or a private view? We can go to HANA Studio, double click on the data model, click on the semantics. Click on View Properties. Once you click on the View Properties, when you don't have a specified, now this is Compact Document Journal. Accounting Document Journal Query. If it is a query, it means that it's a query view. Now, here we have one more view. Here we have one more view. So in this views, so these are physical tables, DKPF. You have FAGLF, LEXA. So anything that is on top of the table directly. And in the description, it is given as private. Or it is directly given on the top of the table. These views are private views. Click back. This is also query view. So this is a private view. vbak_com. Once you click back, this is a reuse view. And this is consumed in a different view. So, sales document header is a reuse view, and when you see query, when you see something for query, it's a query view. So, in the HANA Studio, you can find from the description of the view. So, let us expand one query view. Let us expand one of the query view. Under this query views, you have different views. Now let us select a query view. This is the name of the view. The description of the view, what is the package, what is the application it is associated, view category, query, and the view type is a calculation view. Click on generate SLD file for the selected view. Click on this file. Once you click on this file, there's a file which is generated by system. Click on this file to open the file. So here we have schema, we have the schema, and we have the tables. Now for this query to work, the target schema is SAP_ECC, and these are the table names. So in the HANA Studio, we have to make sure that in the quick view, in the switch ownership, sorry, in the schema mapping, we need to have this SAP_ECC. This is the base schema name and this is the username. Both are mapped together. We need to map with the SLD. So this is our user defined schema. But what is the SLD over here? Let's go to SAP GUI. What is the SLT configuration? Click on SAP Logon. Let me log into SLT system. Provide the username and password. Go to the key code LTRC. Click enter. Provide the mass transfer ID. Click execute. Give the name. So for all these tables, the target. So this is not the target schema, this is the source schema, because we don't have the same schema name. That's why this is the source schema and this is the target schema. So this is equal to this. So both are equal. Source schema is equal to target schema. To change this, so we need to update. So we need to update this in the schema mapping. This is our schema. Then click finish. Now we are done with the schema mapping. Now copy all the tables. What is the query? Sales order query. Copy all the tables. Go to the SLT system. Click data provisioning. So where are we doing this now? We're doing in the development system. In the development SLT, I'm going to execute all these jobs. So I'll go back. I'll click on data provisioning. Click on start load. Click multiple selection. Let's go to the target schema. Don't have any tables here. So let's go to SLT and copy, upload from clipboard, click upload from clipboard, 23 tables. Select single values, 23 tables, click execute, and finally execute. So once we execute, all the 23 tables are excuse me, sorry. All the 23 tables are available for schedule. So we go to HANA Studio. Let's go to Window, Show View, Quick View. Click on Provisioning. Select the system. Click Finish. So ECC SLT 999. So now I schedule the jobs. So all these tables are now load scheduled. So we'll wait for the jobs to get finished. This takes some 2 to 3 minutes. Finish 2 tables. So click Finish. So all the tables are now completed. So once the tables are completed, loading to SAP HANA, then now we are in the invalid views. We already, for this, view name, go to the HANA Studio. Click Refresh. We have all the tables over here. Right click on some of the table, open data preview. It says not authorized. So what we do is we go to the system schema, and system password is same as the best password. W capital welcome 123 and click OK. So both have the same passwords. System and best. So expand the content. go to the ECC. HPA ECC. Expand the calculation views. Right click on the ECC, find. So here you have sales order query. Once you have all the dependency tables, you see the view is inactive. Double click on the view to open. So you open the view. So this view has different master data. Like we have sales order header, which is transaction, sales document type, sales office, sales group, distribution channel, division, customer, sales document header, business data, and finally aggregation. So this is not star join, this is cube. So here, you open the sales order header. Click open. This is another calculation view. So now we are inside the sales order header. So again, sales order header, you have VBUK and VBAK. So there's a join on VBUK and VBAK. So let's open VBAK. In VBAK, this is the data model. VBAK, and here you have the base table. Please see the client here, ECCSLT999.VBAK. So why did we, how did we get ECCSLT by doing schema mapping? Once we do schema mapping, automatically system populates the schema name. Just select the table, right click and data preview. And click raw data. This is the data that SLT has replicated. Let's click back. So what is the type of view here? It's a private view. VBAK.com is a private view. We cannot modify this. Click back. And this VBAK, I'm using this in the sales document header. The sales document header is a reuse view. And sales document header, click back, is used inside the sales order header. So previously is sales document header. Sales document header using in sales doc, sales order header. Sales order header is a reuse view. It means that we are using sales document header inside the sales order header. So a sales order header consists of VBAK and VBUK. There's a join between VBAK and VBUK. The sales order header. Now, in the sales order header, finally I have the sales order query view. So this is the analytical report on the sales list of sales orders. So this is the final query view. So query view, sales order header reuse view, sales document header reuse view, and VBAK.com is a private view. So finally, now all the dependent tables are available. So once all the dependent tables are available, if you don't have these tables, it will show an error. At every stage, it threw an error saying that, I'll just show you how it actually shows. For example, if I open, for example, accounting period. If you don't have any corresponding tables, here we have one predefined data model. So inside the union, it's getting data from different periods. Period 1, period 2. MNDTN period. So, it's created a design time filters on each table based on each period. So, when you don't have PC, you see the indication MNDT is inactive. T000 table is not available. So this is the dependency. So now finally we go to the view. I click find. Sales order query open. Click data preview. Data preview not possible. Either object is either inactive or broken. If it is an inactive object, activate it or else redeploy. So first we will save and validate and click save and activate. Now we need to check for each one of them, each one of the dependent model. I'm activating this data model. So it threw an error when you activate. So we need to check on each of these. For example, I go to sales office. Sales office data preview. I'm seeing only for sales office. Whether we can see data for sales office. Yes, we can see all the sales office. Now, we have to go to distribution channel. Open data preview. Click raw data. I see all the distribution channels. Now we see customer basic data, data preview. So in this way, we have to make sure that all these views are active. We're seeing customer related data, customer district, customer postal code, customer city, sales order header. Data preview. So once you make sure that all these are active and we're able to data preview, then the final query will get activated. In any of these queries, you have inconsistencies. The model will not get active. You have to basically check manually and finally activate based on the errors it threw over here. After you get the required tables from the source system, it's only that there should be something missing. It's a sales document, some T-T007, still some tables or data models. We need to map appropriately. So once these views are active, click on all views. All the activated views will be available in the all views. Expand sales and distribution. So here you have some actuated views. All these are actuated views. So we have a query view, sales office query. So now, here you have various options like open definition, open content, cross, open cross reference, add tags, generate an SLD file, open this in Lumira, open this in Analysis for Office. So if you want to see dependencies, for example, vbuk.com is a private view. Excuse me. If you want to see dependencies, just right click on the view and click open cross reference. Once you click on open cross reference, so vbuk.com is dependent on VBUK. If you open sales organization query, open cross reference. So sales organization is dependent upon TVKOT, TVKO and T001. So in this way, you can see all the cross reference. Sales document header. Open cross reference. The sales document header object is a reuse view. And this is a private view. Open. So this private view again has a reference with sales organization, open. The sales organization has a reference with these dependent tables. So like this we can see all the dependencies using cross reference. So tomorrow we are going to see more details about HANA Live Browser. And we're going to see analytic authorization and then enhancing of the views. How do we enhance the existing views based on the requirement? So we have a custom functionality. How do we enhance the standard views delivered by SAP? What is the best practices we need to follow to enhance this? Just to recap today's session, in today, I'm just showing you what are the different dependencies we have to implement. The first one is we need to check schema mapping. The second one, use the delivery mode to import the objects. Go to the object, check for the dependencies, activate each and every object individually. This is more of troubleshooting and making the objects active in a sidecar scenario. But when you have in the main car, it's very easy to implement. Because already you have all the dependencies. Just we need to activate these data models and transport the data models to the QA and test these data models. Any questions, please ask me. Also, I encourage everyone, based on your subject area, whether you're from FI, whether you're from sales or logistics, please take your respective views and try to analyze. And try to analyze few views. based on your subject area, based on this function area that you're interested. So please go through the package, which is HBA ECC under SAP. So imported sales order query, can I do modifications? For example, if you want to perform joins and projection, yes, you can do, you can copy and you can do. Instead of changing the standard one, if you're not sure, you can first copy, right-click, copy, paste in a different package, and then you can do all the modifications. So how do you fix any errors after SLT loading? You have to check logs, check for this specific dependent views. So you have to write down what are the dependent views. Or I'll also tell you one shortcut using generate auto documentation. In an auto documentation, right click on the view, auto documentation, all the dependencies are given. We need to refer to the dependencies document and make sure all the views are active. Is transformation mandatory in DXC while transferring data from DS to DSO? So DXC, we don't load data to BW. DXC is something which bypass BW and get data to HANA. So there is no loading on the BW side. Now if you enable only to load to HANA, but yes, if you're loading to BW, then the transformation is mandatory. Okay, everyone. Thank you, everyone, to attend today's session. We'll see you tomorrow, same time. Good morning and good night to everyone. Thank you.